Families of the Uvalde shooting victims are demanding accountability after the Justice Department released its scathing report into the law enforcement response to the massacre at Robb Elementary School.
Yeah, let's go now to CNN's Evan Perez. He is on scene there in Uvalde, Texas. And Evan, you just sat down for an exclusive interview with Attorney General Merrick Garland, who was there unveiling this report. What did he say?
Well, Brianna Brewers, you know, not a dry eye in that room as the Attorney General spoke to us. The family members were here for a press conference, and then we sat down with the Attorney General to talk a little bit about his visit here in Uvalde and everything that he finally got to see with his own eyes. Listen to him talk about this. You met with the families here in Uvalde last night. Tell us what you heard from them.
Look, of course, what I heard is enormous pain, as any human being would express, given what happened to their children and their loved ones. I don't want to talk about the details of what they said. You're totally free to talk to them about that. I'll say that I began the day by going through the schoolhouse with a member
Robb Elementary?
Yes, with a member of the elementary, with a member of the expert team. And I'll say it is considerably different. I had long ago read the entire report, but being there, seeing how small the two schoolrooms are, and their attachment to each other, the holes in the wall left by the shooters, the places where the children tried to hide, it's just a different experience, both in terms of understanding why tactics were wrong, but also in terms of understanding what happened. We then went to the murals that are painted of each of the children who died. And we saw joyous figures. You know, they intentionally painted them to express the children's joy of life and enormous energy. And you know, just think about the difference between that and what happened to them. And then after that, we went and met with the families who, as I said, expressed pain, anger, and every human emotion that you would expect.
Does it anger you going through that school? I mean, it's not a sprawling place, and to know that there were 370 or so police officers standing outside while these children and these teachers were trapped with this shooter for so long, does it anger you to sort of just put yourself in that place?
Yes, it makes me angry that this event had to happen in the first place. The shooter could come in with a military-grade weapon and kill students and teachers. And it angers me that the tactics used were the opposite of the tactics that were appropriate in an active shooter situation. That's the reason we did this report, so that we could tell the community exactly what happened, but also so that we could prevent this kind of thing from happening again from the point of view of a response, by making sure that all police departments are well aware of the generally accepted tactic in this kind of situation.
One of the things, you know, reading this report, nearly 600 pages, you know, some of the things that stand out, you know, 45 rounds fired by this shooter while law enforcement is present, you know, families being told that their loved ones are alive when they were not. You know, the false information that was coming from those press conferences, beginning with the one by Governor Abbott and then going through the Department of Public Safety. Do you, looking at what you see in this report, do you believe that anyone who was involved in that response still belongs serving in law enforcement right now?
Look, so the Justice Department doesn't have jurisdiction over these kind of personnel questions. What we can do and what we've done in this report is to identify minute by minute, sometimes second by second, what was happening, what the failures of leadership of law enforcement on the scene were, as well as the failures of preparation in advance and of the aftermath of the way things went afterwards in terms of communications, in terms of medical assistance and when it was provided. And in terms of the misinformation thereafter. And I think it's now up to the community, the state and local officials, to make the appropriate determinations.
You know, this is a tiny police department here that was responding. Is it reasonable to think that departments that small would have that kind of training, would have this kind of preparation that maybe bigger city police departments would have?
Yeah. So after Columbine, every police department should have had this kind of training. I would say for myself and everybody else who's a leader in law enforcement today, 25 years later, Columbine is seared into our memories. But it is true that in all of these situations, a more regional response is required. There were a lot of law enforcement agencies on the scene. As you said, there were more than 300 responders from different agencies. And what's necessary is for them to all train together, not for the first time when the incident occurs, so that if everybody trains together and gets the equipment that the various different local agencies have in the right place at the right time, that's a way to protect ourselves in the future.
Brianna and Boris, it's clear from the Attorney General today there were lives lost unnecessarily. Lives could have been saved if police had acted in a better fashion that day. One of the big questions, obviously, is the question of accountability. His visit here has brought back the flooding back the memories of what happened at Robb Elementary. And so one of the big questions is, what happens with an investigation being led by the local district attorney, who says that investigation is still ongoing? That is not something the Justice Department is in charge of, and so we wait to see whether anything happens from that local investigation. Boris and Brianna.